welcome you to the Festival of Praise, conducted by our guest conductor, the world-renowned composer, conductor, and humorist, Pepper Choplin. It's been our honor and our great joy to sing with Pepper Choplin as he directs many of his works. And you've probably heard many of his works, his anthems, his cantatas, and our hymns. It's such a gift to welcome Pepper Choplin into our community, and many thanks to the Center for Congregations that's given us this great opportunity. Let us begin with prayer. Our most gracious and loving God, we love you, and we lift our continued worship to you as we sing your praise this day. Bless each of us here this day with your Holy Spirit, that in listening we may learn of your kingdom, your joy, your love, as we sing your praise. Amen.
Thank you. I am Pepper Choplin, and I'm so glad that you're here today. We're going to have a good time, and I want to, this looks like a really sophisticated audience as I look across the crowd, and I want you to help us sing this first song. It's called Day to Sing Hosanna. Some people think, oh, that's a great Palm Sunday piece, but really every day is a good day to sing Hosanna, and it includes a stomp part and a clapping part. And I don't trust this crowd to sing, hold their folder, clap, and stomp at the same time. So your part is to stomp and to clap. Could you do this after me? Everybody. Oh, that's good.
Thank you.
And so I started thinking, we are not alone. What if I'd only had one note? And I said, well, is that really possible? He said, well, Maurice Ravel did Bolero, and that's one note. And he did it for 15 minutes. I could do it at least for 2.5 minutes. And so I tried to do that, really keeping the discipline. I just wanted to add some words, but I said, no, just get one thought. And after we sang it for my church, my daughter came in and she said, you know, I can't get that phrase out of my head. I said, yes, victory. Because it's a wonderful thing to remember, and people have given their testimony saying that, oh, I really just needed to hear that. We are not alone. We are not alone. God is with us.
This is Shelley Fitz,
for our soloist.
We are not alone, we are not alone, right?
going to Scotland with me next week. And we're going to be doing a tour of about 4 or 5 concerts in Scotland. And this is one of the pieces. And this will be for the men. And the men, as you can look at the men, they are really kind of showboats. And they're very entertaining personalities. Well, some of them are. But we'd like to do Standing in the Need of Prayer. And we'd like to have our soloist, Jabari Hunter.
Not my brother, not my sister, but it's me, O Lord.
Standing in the need of prayer.
Not my brother, not my sister, but it's me, O Lord.
Standing in the need of prayer.
It's me,
it's me, it's me, O Lord. Standing in the need of prayer.
Thank you.
That's been sung in a lot of churches and many schools because it says, fill me up, O Holy Spirit. So many things try to fill me up. So many things try to weigh me down. So many things try to make me go astray. But fill me up my heart and let it grow and change my life so the world will know. And our soloist is Jonathan Clark. And so I'd like to share with you one of the stories that's in this book for this next piece that we're going to sing, This Is My Word. What does it mean to give one's life to the ministry of the Word? I reflected on this question when I was commissioned to write a piece for a pastor who was retiring in South Carolina. Pastors aren't the only one who gives themselves to the ministry. All Christians are called to ministry, and we answer that call in many ways. As I searched for scriptures in this for a suitable text, I wanted to see what God said about God's word. This led me to the beautifully picturesque passage of Isaiah 55, 10 through 12. The scripture laid out a natural flow for a song and even provided a strong hook. In verse 10, the rain and the snow, the seed and the sower lead to the phrase, "So is my word." With a bit of poetic flair, I crafted the scripture into the first two verses. Then for the third verse, I responded to the scripture and expressed my feelings at that time. O Lord, when I am weary, when I feel the days I'm living are in vain, my God, help me be faithful to the word you have given to proclaim. And God calls us to be faithful, not to be always successful. Encouragement arrives in the promise of verses 11 and 12. God's word will not return empty, but will accomplish what God desires. Then the celebration begins. You will go out with joy and be led forth in peace. And to crown the statement, I hearken back to the parable of the talents and echo the words of the master. And when your earthly journey here is done, I'll say well done. And I think that well done part is why so many people have embraced this anthem. In our difficulty, what a joy to think that God is pleased with our efforts and will one day say those words to us in heaven, well done, my good and faithful servant. And an extra thought I put in the book. As you serve, do you feel the days you are living are in vain? To those who are faithful to their calling, God says, well done, my good and faithful servant.
Oh,
the next anthem, One Step He Leads, I thought it would be just kind of a fun gospel song to sing, lighthearted. But after it was published, I started getting more testimonies about this song than any others that I had ever written. So many people said things like, you know, Pepper, when I was going through my cancer treatments, I just one step, that's all that helped me hold on. One step he leads, one step he falls. When my wife or my husband died after that, I just had to hold on to these words. One step, just one day at a time. God knows my needs, and he will supply. Same time I was considering going off and being a full-time composer and leaving my church position that I'd been for over 20 years, and in the middle of the night, if you've ever been gone freelance, in the middle of the night when I was wondering if I should really do this, I made the decision, yes, I am going to do this, and this is what God is leading me to do. I said, okay, how are you going to lead your church? What message would you lead the church with? And I just put my hands on the piano, and this really simple song came out, and I just gravitated to that 1 John 4:7-8. Beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God, and everyone who loves is born of God. And if you don't love, you're not born of God. And that just resonated with me because of all of those years of ministry in a church. We've been through so many campaigns to build buildings and to feed the hungry and to work on our children's ministry. But if we can't get the love thing right in a church, we have no message. We've got to get the love thing right. And so this is what I left with my church, and this is what we share with you to remind us that love is the key, love conquers all.
Thank you.
let us share this music. You should be very proud of your community and your singers. I have just had a wonderful time working with people, and yeah. And we really appreciate Joyce. Raise your hand, Joyce. She's put so much work into this. And also, Holly on the piano. She's been just a great job. So, I just had a good time in Indiana. And later on, we're going to have some refreshments out in the lobby. And right in front of where the refreshments are is a table with my books and CDs. It's just blocking, you know, sort of blocking. And with every purchase, you get some of the refreshments. I just wanted to really, there. I've got some CD there. I've got two humor CDs that are really actually funny. They're called Pepper Is My Real Name. It's called one. And another is Might As Well Laugh Than Cry. That's what my mom used to say. And then there's one called Hold On, which is me singing inspirational kind of pieces with everything from just piano to full orchestra. And then there will be my book, Million Notes. And I tell people, I just wanted to point out that I do take cash, checks, or credit cards. And even if you don't buy anything, I still take cash, checks, and credit cards. Just keep that in mind. I do not turn down anything since COVID. But this last piece, I just love the sound. I was sitting on Christmas Day. The movie Cold Mountain had just come out. And in the middle of that, right before the hero is going off to war, they are in a little tiny clapboard church, and they are singing with gusto this hymn, I'm Going Home. And you see Judd Law and Nicole Kidman hitting their leg, singing this to the top of their lungs. I said, I've got to do an arrangement of that piece. So this is it. It's called I'm Going Home. We'll do this piece, have a prayer, and then send you off with a benediction song.
Safe and just be with us in your name that we pray. Amen.
just take our picture, then we welcome. Why don't you go listen to you?
We need to stand up here.
That's right.